hundreds of bodies found in unmarked graves at former Saskatchewan residential school.
Here's a summary of the article.
The total number of graves near the former Maryville Indian Residential School is expected to be over 3 times higher than the 215 discovered recently in Kamloops, Ottawa. A Saskatchewan First Nation says it has made the horrific and shocking discovery of hundreds of unmarked graves, many believed to be children, near a former residential school, with a total expected to be over 3 times higher than the 215 discovered recently in Kamloops, BC, according to a source briefed on the file. Leaders of the Cowessess First Nation, a roughly 2-hour drive east of Regina, are expected to reveal details of the macabre discovery near what was once the Maryville Indian Residential School during a press conference Thursday morning, as well as the latest count of newly identified remains. The remains are in unmarked graves in a communal gravesite first used in 1885 but eventually taken over by the Maryville Indian Residential School, founded and operated by the Roman Catholic Church beginning in 1899 on what was then the Maryville Reserve. The discovery comes less than a month after the unthinkable discovery of the remains of 215 Indigenous children, some as young as 3 years old, in unmarked graves near the Kamloops Indian Residential School outside Kamloops, BC. James Doshchuk, a University of Regina Health and Indigenous History researcher, applauded Chief DeLorme's decision to pursue these searches despite the horrific findings likely to emerge. Students at Maryville Indian Residential School were no exception to that. According to information published in Shattering the Silence, The Hidden History of Indian Residential Schools in Saskatchewan, a historical report published by the University of Regina's Faculty of Education. Reports dating back to 1919 note that authorities expected school staff to physically dominate students, and that an Indian agent refused to transfer a student to another school because he feared that the other boys may form the opinion that the brother is afraid of the big boys.
This post received a score of 44,000, with an upvote ratio of 93%. Here are the top comments in response to this article.
A doctor investigated these schools in 1907 only to be blacklisted by the Canadian government. He recorded a mortality rate of up to 69% at some of these schools. Here is a link to the news article. Dr. Bryce.
That's more than twice as much as the average, p.13, at the time. Correction, that includes the extra high death rate under a year. They'd attend as young as 4 years old, so it's probably more like 10x the death rate.
Page 13 says mortality rate is 19.2% in the first year of life and 4.1% in the second. I doubt these residential schools were full of infants.
The question here turns into, how many more sites are there like this? It seems more than reasonable to expect that the administration and staff at these schools were all in on this practice.
Seems safe to assume one per school.
Yeah, and this isn't really new news. It is pretty widely known there are a lot of unmarked graves at these sites. It's sickening. Edit. If you're interested in knowing more, please read Indian Horse by Richard Wagamese. It's an Indigenous university, and has a wonderful, though heartbreaking, history museum. Then there's another marker, further off towards the woods, where the suspected unmarked graves are. Those poor children, and their families, deserved so much better. I read an article today that the university will likely be included in upcoming investigations to find more of these sites.
This was done deliberately, in an attempt to do to the Indigenous peoples of Canada what Hitler tried to do to the Jews. Canada was trying to wipe out their civilizations by murdering or stealing all of their children. Now they do it by forcing them onto reservations with little in the way of resources, sending the cops after them to spread terror, and stealing what little they have left by building oil pipelines directly through their homes.
And the thing is, people act like this was hundreds of years ago. I'm 26, the youngest grandchild of an Indian residential school survivor. Not only did my grandmother get severely abused throughout her childhood, but both my mother and uncle were wrongly taken away from her. I tried writing about it years back, but I still can't emotionally handle talking about what happened to my family. I'm 25 and son of a residential school survivor. I do not know how to process all the things that have happened. How can I participate in a society that's done us so wrong?
It took China damn near 100 years to bounce back from something like the opiate trade in their territories stolen by the British. Now imagine slavery, having your culture ripped from you. Having your children permanently disappear just to be found buried beneath a school. Europeans and their settlers walked off scot-free without a care in the world, their lives on an upward trajectory.
This video was automatically created by Reddit to speech. The article and comments in this video were selected from Reddit according to their upvotes, and any paraphrasing was performed by smmry.com, without any human intervention.